In this presentation, we'll look at the S/4HANA structure. One major difference between SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA is the Universal Journal. This Universal Journal acts as a common table between general ledger accounting, asset accounting, controlling, material ledger, and so on. For example, in the SAP ERP system, you have separate line item tables. For general ledger, BSEC table, asset accounting, you have it in ANEP table, NLC table, controlling, you can have it in COEP table, COEJ table, material ledger will have their MSEC table and so on, made up of multiple different line item tables. However, in S/4HANA, one universal journal table called ACDOCA or ACDOCA contains all of these modules information in one single table entry. This makes it much easier for reconciliation. In this diagram, we can see this in more detail. For example, in your general ledger tables, you will have your company code, general ledger account, amount, profit center, currency, and so on. These are all copied to the universal journal table. In fixed asset accounting, you have your fixed asset number, sub number, and so on. These are also copied across to Universal Journal table. The material ledger information such as material code and so on also copied over here, as well as your controlling information such as your controlling area, cost element, cost center and so on, including the profitability analysis segments like market segment, customer group and whatever other profitability segments you have will also get copied over to the Universal Journal. Another major difference between SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA is the removal of tables, such as index tables, aggregate tables, and some line item tables. Now, these are not completely gone from S/4HANA. However, they have something called a proxy table, and sometimes the table names start with a V underscore and the table name, for example, V underscore COEP, or if it's a fixed asset table, it could be like FAA V underscore ANEP and so on. So let's look at some of the legacy index tables like BCs, BSAS, BSID, BSAD. This is all relevant to GL open items, custom open items, and then you have your window open items, as well as some of the new GL open items tables such as FAGL BSIS, FAGL BSAS and so on. This all will no longer be necessary in S/4HANA because they all will be available in the Universal Journal table ACDOCA. For planning, you can have the table ACDOCP, and for certain total item, there's also another table which you can refer to called ACDOCT that will replace most of the totals table, or called as aggregate tables, which have also been removed as I shown in this column over here, such as COSS, COSP and so on. The other tables which are removed but indexed via proxy tables are FAGL FlexA, COEP, ANEP, ANEA, ANLC, ANLP and so on. So just to summarize, the index tables, aggregate tables and certain line item tables have been removed and been replaced by the Universal Journal. Another advantage of the Universal Journal is its extensibility. Your custom fields, your GL coding block fields and your COPA custom fields can all be added to the Universal Journal. For example, the custom fields you create for your COPA value fields and characteristics, which usually start with your VV and WW and so on, can also be added to the Universal Journal table along with your coding block fields for your general ledger if you want extensive reporting facilities. These are all can be displayed via your ACDOCA table, which is a Universal Journal table. So how the journal entry works in the Universal Journal entry is the header table still remains the same. The BKPF header table for financial accounting is still the same as in SAP ERP. However, the line item table ACDOCA, which is a Universal Journal entry table, will contain all the line items required for you to process the information. In addition, certain limitations which happen in the BSEC table in SAP ERP, such as the line item number, which was limited to 3 digits, has now been increased to 6 digits in ACDOCA table, which means you could probably load more than 1000 line items in one single entry. Also, the currency fields has been upgraded to 23 digits, so you can have a very large number followed by multiple decimals. Let's look at what is consistent between SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. The document number is still consistent using the BELNAR field. The header document number, BKPF table and BELNAR field is the same as the line item tables ACDOCA and BELNAR. So the document number, as before in SAP ERP, is dependent on company code and fiscal year. Another new functionality with SAP S/4HANA is the introduction of the extension ledger. You can also call it as an appendix ledger, mainly because it just sits on top of another ledger. This is a new concept which is introduced in S/4HANA, which did not exist in SAP ERP. This extension ledger is used for adjustments or consolidation purpose by companies where they only want to book entries on the extension ledger. So rather than creating a separate ledger and copying over all the general ledger entries, which usually is the leading ledger 0L, and then adding on the extension ledger entries, SAP simply created an extension ledger where it automatically copies over all the 0L entries as well as the new extension ledger entries, which is unique to the extension ledger. So when you create an appendix ledger or an extension ledger in SAP, you tag it as an extension ledger and link that to a base leading ledger, in many cases 0L. This greatly reduces the database space, which is required to have a separate extension ledger. If you are migrating from a legacy SAP environment to S/4HANA, rather than doing a complete clean installation, you can still use your existing custom programs. However, if you are planning to do a fresh SAP S/4HANA implementation, which is often the recommended approach given by SAP, then you will have to rewrite your custom programs. If you are simply migrating, or this is just like doing an upgrade from a legacy system to S/4HANA, then all your existing custom programs will still work. During the installation process, the compatibility views are created, which will allow you to read the information. However, the legacy programs with write access to old tables, such as we discussed before, will cause trouble. Hence, it's better to rewrite the write access programs again. Anyway, just to recap, SAP does recommend, for if you're going for SAP S/4HANA, use it as an opportunity to do a fresh SAP installation. Hence, you might find some of the custom programs which you used to have before in your legacy SAP ERP system will not be required, as there might be better ways of using SAP S/4HANA, especially with the option of the Universal Journal Entry table. Just quickly revisiting the functionality and benefits of S/4HANA, the single source of truth, that is the Universal Journal Entry table, by just accessing one single table, you will be able to capture all the information by just looking into one extract of a database table. Previously, you had to consolidate multiple tables and use primary keys and foreign keys to find a common ground to link many of those tables. Also, with real-time processing using S/4HANA and reduced data footprint, because no totals tables are required and no secondary indices tables are required, by just having one single table, you have significantly reduced your data footprint. This allows for faster reporting and makes it much easier to plan and analyze the results. Just quickly recap what's changed with S/4HANA Finance. Some tables have been removed, such as your index tables, totals tables, and certain line item tables. The single journal entry table format consists of all GL, asset accounting, controlling, material ledger details. You can still access some legacy tables by view of proxy tables, which point to those legacy tables still in S/4HANA. However, it's much easier to use a universal journal entry table. In the universal journal entry table, you could see all the ledger information as well. profit center accounting, special purpose ledger, consolidation, these still remain the same. However, there's one major change with regard to controlling in the universal generated table is in the universal generated table, you will see the account based COPA. We will come to COPA later when you come in the presentations for that. But just to give an insight, the universal generated table will have the account based COPA only. For costing based COPA, we can still use their own legacy tables and the run reports. But with using SO HANA Finance, the recommended approach is now to use account based COPA, as we can have more detailed line item analysis by using that costing method. So now we had a look at how the SO HANA structure is applied. Now in the next presentation, we look at the reporting options.